Hello everyone, welcome to our PBL Level 1 Physics project. Today we're going to talk about geometric optics. In our experiment, we're going to find a focal length of this converging lens. And it is going to be an investigation kind of experiment, and it's going to be inquiry based. We're going to give the materials to the students, and then we're going to ask them to find the focal length. And then they're going to figure out what to measure, how to measure, how to change, what to change. And in the analysis part, we're going to need to help the students a little bit because the equation of like focal length equation is going to be a little bit difficult to align with the line equation. So we're going to talk about that. So let's move to our materials part and let's introduce our materials for the experiment. All right, materials of this experiment, you can, if you buy Pasco's optic basic set, you're gonna have all of the materials and more actually, but we're going to use some of them. First, we're going to have basic light source. So that is going to be our light source, and then we're going to use this part of it. So that is going to be our object. So we're gonna have light inside, and when you light it on, then this is going to be our object. And next, we're going to need a screen to be able to place the image. And we're going to need a lens, converging lens, of any size. Or if you buy it with the set, then you already have like lenses already that is going to go with the optic bench. So you don't need to have a separate one like this, like a single lens. And we're going to have this adjustable lens holder. So since I'm using this lens, I'm going to need that lens holder. All right, and I'm going to show you how to set it up. So you can measure the radius of your lens, and my lens is 50 centimeters, actually 50 millimeters, so it's 5 centimeters. So what you do is, as you can see, those sides are able to move, all right? So all you need to do is, first you're going to set up the bottom, those two first, to 50. And once it's at 50, you just screw them in and you put that to 52. And that is going to be ready. And now what you're going to do is you're going to place this guy. You're going to leave this guy like free to move. So you're going to place your lens. And once it's placed, what you're going to do is you're going to push the top one. And make sure that it is going to be in place. And once it's in place, you're going to, it should show you 50 exactly. You just press it and make sure that it is there. All right, so now we set it up and it is ready. All right, so our lens and lens holder is ready. And the last thing that we're gonna need is gonna be the optic bench, which is going to be, again, part of the optics basic set. So these are the materials, and now we're going to move to conduction of the experiment. All right, the setup is pretty simple. You just need to be careful with the lens light and face, that light side should face to the screen. So that's all you need to do, and make sure that, I mean, you don't have to put it to zero, but since this is your object, if you place it to zero, and as you can see, that's pretty simple to take it in and take it out. So you have this bottom, like this part, you can press it. Or if you want to mount it to the track, you just put it and press it from the top. Since these are all the part of the same kit, they're all gonna work the same way. You just put it, press it in, put it, and press it in. So they all work the same way. And the lens is going to be in between the screen and our light source. And then we're going to move our light source to zero. And what we're going to do, well, this is going to be students' investigation. You're going to give those materials, and then your question is simple. How do you find the focal length of the lens? All right, so that's the question. But since they already introduced, or it's up to you if you don't want, introduce the equation, but if they know the equation, they're going to know you need to find the position of the object, and then you're going to need to find a position of the image, and over there you also have the focal length equation. That is going to be the equation, and I'm going to introduce how to do the experiment and how to find the numerical value and how to analyze our data. All right, this is the setup, and again, like I said, the question is how do you find the focal length? So what we're going to do is, since after the focal length you're going to have real images, you just need to figure out what your at what positions you're going to be able to find an image. All right, so let your kids figure that out, but for my lens, I'm going to start from 30 centimeters. All right, first I'm going to place my lens to 30 centimeters, and since my object is at 30 centimeters, my distance of the object from the lens is going to be 30 centimeters. And I am going to figure out where my image is, and how do I figure this out? By moving it back and forth. So you're going to move the screen back and forth, and whenever you see the image clear, then you're going to hold it there, and that is going to be the position of the image. But most of the time, kids are having problems with the distance of the image, because for example, right now it's at 104, so they are counting from zero. But the position of the image is from lens to the image. So make sure that they are measuring the distance from your lens to the screen, and that is position of the image. And wherever your lens is, that is the position of the object, because your object is located at zero. Again, that setup is up to your students, but if you keep one of them at zero and keep the lens at any distance that you want, then the calculations are going to be a little bit easier. And to be able to find a focal length, what do I need to do? So you can ask your students for them to find the equation or find the graph that they need to have to be able to find a focal length, because the equation is a little bit complicated. 1 over focal length equals 1 over SI, position of the image, plus 1 over SO, which is position of the object. So how do we make this Y equals MXR to be? How do you make this Y equals MX plus B format? How do we write it down? So that's a little bit difficult. So you can ask your student first to figure out what is change. So what are we changing? What are we measuring? What can we change in the setup? And what can we measure in the setup? So then, of course, the answer for the changing variable is we cannot change the position of the image, but we can change the position of the object. So my SO is the changed variable. So that is going to go to your x-axis. And then what do we measure, or what can we measure? We are going to be able to measure the position of the image. So that means that is going to be your dependent variable, and that is going to go to your y-axis. So then now I know what y is, and I know what x is. And then we're going to need to refer to the equation, 1 over f equals 1 over si plus 1 over so. And then we're going to convert that equation to our straight line equation. All right, the analysis part of this experiment is a little bit difficult, so students are going to need your help. So the line equation equals y equals mx plus b, but that is a mathematical form. So for a line on the x and y, if you have a straight line, this is your y intercept, and your slope is your m. All right, so basically that's what this equation is. So we are trying to find a straight line. So our equation is 1 over focal length equals 1 over si plus 1 over so. All right, so the question is, how do you convert this guy to this guy? So that is, again, like, it's not going to be easy for students to figure out, so they're going to need your help. So you can start with, what should we have on the x-axis? Because in physics, you cannot put anything on the x-axis. So on the x-axis, we're going to have the change variables. So what are we changing in our experiment? So we are changing the position of the object. So that is going to go to the x. So, or anything that I do with the SO is going to go to the x-axis. And then what do I measure? I am measuring the SI. So that is going to go to my y-axis. So on the x, I'm going to have SO. On the y, I'm going to have SI related something. And I'm trying to figure out what my focal length is. So everything is 1 over f, 1 over si, 1 over so. So if I want to convert that to that form, then what's going to change? I'm looking for this one question mark, and on the y-axis, that's what I have. So y equals mx plus b. So what are we going to do? We're going to isolate this y in our equation. All right, now we need to isolate y over here. So basically, 1 over si equals what? 1 over focal length minus 1 over SO. So this is my y, this is my x. So from the equation, well, this part is a little bit tricky, but this number, this negative 1 in front of my x, according to this equation, that's my slope. And actually, our slope is already like negative 1, so that is going to be choose as our slope. So we're now going to look at the slope this time. So what's left? This guy. So over here, y, m, x, we already defined what they are. So the only thing that is left is b. Then 1 over focal length is going to be my b. So your graph is going to look like this. So you're going to have 1 over si over here, 1 over so over here. And this y-intercept is going to be your 1 over focal length. All right, the other important thing that you need to warn your students when you are during this graph, they need to have the scale of 0 on both so that they can figure out the b correctly. Well, if they make the calculations correctly, there's no problem. You don't have to start with 0, but most of the time, to be on the safe side, tell them to start with the 0, or they should figure that out. All right, so this is one way to find it. And the other one is a little bit like algebraic method. So what you do is you just solve this for f. So if you solve this for f, 1 over focal, 1 over equals 1 over si plus 1 over so. So if you solve this for f, what are you going to have? 1 over f equals, you're going to have so here, si here. Then you're going to have so plus si divided by si times so. So that's what you have. But I'm trying to find my focal length. So flip both sides. So your f equals si times so divided by so plus si. So what is this? Basically, f equals si times so divided by so plus si. So that means if you have rise over run graph, which means si, so to so plus si on the x-axis, your slope is going to give you what? Your focal length. So like we discussed, in either case, you're going to need si and so. And once you know those values, you're going to be able to figure out your focal length. So I'm going to start with 30. And I'm going to increase that distance by 5, and I'm going to try to locate my image. So when it's at 30, again, what do? I just move this back and forth, and I try to find the perfect image. All right, so that's kind of a little, like, that's a little bit challenging because finding the perfect image is not as, like, it's not easy. But when you have, since we are having an experiment, moving, having more and more data is going to make our like data is more clear. So it's better to have like 6 or 7 data if you can. But if you can, 5 is going to be enough too. But finding the perfect image is not really simple. All right, so when it's at 30 centimeters, my image is at 105. But again, we need to be careful. But the position of the image is not 105. Position is from lens to the screen. So since my lens is at 30 centimeters, then my image is going to be at 75. All right, so SO is 30, SI is 75. So you always get the difference from lens to the screen. Then I'm going to move it 5 more centimeters to 35. So another important thing, sometimes kids are trying to move, like taking that distance. You see that distance as like the position, but it's already clearly indicated over here. That's where the lens is. So you need to be careful. And then you need to make sure that this line over there is showing the R 35. All right. So that's at 35 right now. And again, I don't have any image right here, so what do? I move it back and forth, and I try to find the perfect image. The clear image, and it is somewhere over here. So whenever I move it to 35, now my image is at 90. So SO is 35. And SI is the difference from 90 minus 35, which is 55. All right, then I'm going to move it 5 centimeters more. So I'm going to move it to 40. And now move it a little bit closer and try to form the image. All right, so it is around 86. All right, so what you can ask your students during the experiment, you can ask for their observations, like what is happening to the image as you get closer and closer, or as you go more like away from the mirror or from the lens, what happens to the image, what happens to the size of it, what happens to the distance in between. So you can ask questions like that during the experiment, or you can get them write that on their lab report. So now I'm at 40, and my image is at 86. So that means object SO is 40 centimeters, and SI is 46 centimeters. I'm going to move it 5 more to 45. And now, so they might think that they are always going to bring it closer and closer. But at this point, if you bring it more and more, like closer, then it doesn't get clear. So what should you do? You might need to move it a little bit backward. All right, so I moved it a little bit forward. But if you think about the distance in between them, that's a little bit like the distance is not the same. So my distance from the object right now is 45 centimeters, and I located my image at 85.5. So that's at 45, that's 85.5. So distance is 40.5. And I'm keep moving 5 more. And now instead of coming closer, you need to go backward right now. But you're not going to go like 5 centimeters. You're going to go a little bit less than that. So I'm at 50 centimeters. Object to lens is 50. And my image on this rag is 87. So the distance from the lens to the screen is going to be 37. And my last data is going to be from 55 centimeters. And whenever I have it 55, I need to move it a little bit backward. And my image is it going to be at 90 again. So here to here, that's 55. And from lens to screen, it is 35 right now. So these are my data. And we already discussed how we're going to calculate the focal length. So you can use either of the methods. You can either use a y-intercept, and you can use y equals mx plus b equation, or you can make that f equals to like a over b format. Then you're going to need to have si times so, and you're going to need si plus SO. In both ways, you're going to be able to calculate your data. And let's put them to our program, and let's draw our graph, and let's measure the focal length of our lens. Now we have collected our data, and now we show how to analyze that one too. So let's proceed. So we have our data's positions of the object. We started with 30, and then we increase it by 5. And then we measured where our images are. And I'm going to use both of the methods to find the slope, the focal length of our lens. So in one of them, we're going to need 1 over si to 1 over so. So all we need to do is we know all of the si's and so's. So we just need to calculate 1 over si's and 1 over so's. So equal. So 1 divided by SI. So these are my position of the images. So that is going to be it. And the other thing, these are all in centimeters. So since everything is in centimeters, you don't need to convert anything to meters. That is going to be fine. And I am going to make this in thousands. Thousands is going to work. Or, all right, let's keep it that way. And I'm going to need 1 over SOs equals 1 divided by 30s. So it is going to be, when you double click on this, that's going to make the data all the way down. So for SO, you can keep it here, or let's do both of them the same. All right. And over here, I'm going to need SI plus SO. So that's equal to plus SO. So double click. And that is going to be SI times SO. So equals that times that. And you are going to need this guy. All right, so now we have 1 over SI and 1 over SO, both of them. And what we're going to do is we're going to plot them. And I'm going to use my Pasco for this. And I'm going to need table and graph. So select measurement, create new, user enter data. And that is going to be image. And it doesn't matter. So I'm going to use 1 over SI's first. Copy them all. Paste them all. And I am going to need SO's. Copy them all. And select measurements. Create new. User enter data. And that's going to be object. And paste them all. All right. So that, like we discussed, on the x-axis, we're going to have the measured data, change variable. So since we are measuring the object's position, we're going to have object on the x-axis. So select measurement, we're going to have object on the X, and I'm going to need image on the Y. So as you can see, that's a pretty nice data. And what we need is we're going to need our y-intercept. All right, so for this, I'm going to need the tools to measure the slope. And that is already measuring it, but we just need to specify what kind of line this is. So that is a straight line, so I'm going to need that. And once you click on it, as you can see, that's a pretty nice data. Your y-intercept is 0.047. So that means your y-intercept is 1 over focal. So your 1 over focal is equal to that. So to be able to find a focal length, I'm going to go back and I'm going to find a 1 over focal. So it is basically equal 1 over focal length is that. So if 1 over focal is equal to this number, let's record that one over here first, 0.04. So that is my B. So 1 over focal length is that. Then what is my focal length? It is going to be 1 over B. That is equal 1 divided by this guy. So it tells you 21. So my focal length of the lens is 21. So this is from the first method. And let's see what we're going to get from the second method. So from the second method, which one should we have on the X? Which one should we have on the X-axis? All right, the product is going to be our Y-axis. So copy them all. And we have image on the Y. So paste them all to Y, and I am going to need SI plus SO on the X. So select them all, copy them all, and paste them right here. So what did we get? So as you can see from here, our slope is giving our data, like our focal length for this data point is going to be the slope. So my slope is going to be, my slope is 22.2. So which one did we, so as you can see in both methods, we find the focal length, and one of them it's 21.1 and the other is 22.2. And the experimental, these are my experimental, and the theoretical value was 20 centimeters. So as you can see, we're pretty close. So you can ask your students, what are the uncertainties? So what is the reason for the mistakes? And as you can see, which method is closer to the actual value? So the first method using the line equation was pretty, it was closer. Then the second one, because over here you're just using the math, but this is the actual line equation. So that's why this is a more accurate result. All right, but in both we are pretty close to our actual answer. All right, so that is basically our experiment, and that's how we analyze our data. So we did our experiment, and let's see what are the science practices that we cover in this experiment. Students can justify the selection of the kind of the data needed to answer a particular scientific question. So over here, students has used a lens equation, and then they also figured out how to manipulate that equation and how to make it look like a line equation. Or they, in the second method as well, they were trying to figure out how to manipulate the data, and then you can find a focal length from the graph. The second one is, students can collect data to answer a particular scientific question. Well, they collected data of SO and SI, and the purpose of that collection was basically to figure out what the focal length is. And the last one was, students can analyze data to identify patterns or relationship. So we collected the data, and then we analyze our experiment, like we manipulated the data and we make it look like the line equation. And after that, which part is equal to my focal length? So they were able to figure this out after the graph, so they were able to analyze the graph. And basically, these are the science practices that we covered in this experiment. And basically, we're done over here. So thank you for watching and see you next time.